Here at CES, one of the big things that's going on is ag tech and how technology is changing the way we farm, the way we produce our crops in the country. Joining me to talk about this is Jeff Runde, Engineering Director for John Deere. Thank you, Jeff, for joining us.
Yeah, welcome to the booth here. Yeah. Showing a lot of autonomy, our new autonomy applications on our large ag tractor back here. This is a 9RX 830. It happens to be the largest production tractor on the planet right now.
It's pretty huge.
It's pretty big.
I haven't seen anything this massive before.
Yep, it's a little bit bigger than the tractors we've had at CES in the past years. But we wanted to bring the biggest one this year.
And so as an engineer, what have you done to make this so user-friendly and just what we need in the field today?
Yeah, so we do quite a bit of work with our farm customers. So we're always out in the field interviewing different users of the tractor, understanding their use cases, the different practices and different jobs that they need to do. So we take that feedback that really impacts how we do like our user experience up in the displays in the cab. It impacts our web tool, what you can do there, and our mobile phone app and really everything.
And what can this vehicle do that the one before it couldn't do?
So what we're showing here is our Rev2 autonomy system. A few years ago, we released at CES the Rev1 system, so that was the original. The technology advances so fast that we were able to increase the capabilities of the machine. It can see farther, it can see wider, allows us to go a little bit faster, opens up a lot more jobs for the customer to essentially run autonomy on.
So you're telling me nobody has to be in that vehicle to run it?
Correct. So John Deere, we've been building tractors a lot smaller than this. We've built up to this for the last 100 years. We've been manufacturing tractors for the last 20 years. You as a customer could buy a hands-free guidance system. The vast majority of big acre farming in the United States these days is actually planted by a computer. The computer is steering the tractor most of the time in the field. It's almost a component or system in the vehicle that our farmers, it's almost a requirement, right? Like the heater needs to work, the hands-free guidance system needs to work to get the job done today.
Do you need an internet connectivity? Because one of the things in rural America is the internet and the unreliability of it. Do you need an internet connection to make this work?
Every one of our vehicles here on the show floor and the vast majority of the vehicles that we produce have a telematics modem installed in them. That lets the machine connect back and send and receive data essentially from our operations center, which is our web cloud-based tool that you as a customer can log into, and you can see the agronomic data. If you're a customer, say, and you had your harvester, your combine running, then you can go back and look at the yield data, for example, that combine recorded for you. There's other data like machine data that goes back and forth that essentially augments the ownership experience of the machine.
You're able to set up your plan for what you're going to farm. Also, you're getting feedback on what's happening with your crops as well, right?
Correct. So in the downtime, we see a lot of our customers will plan for what the next year is going to be. Like this field, we're going to plant this specific crop, this other field, different crop kind of thing. And create all of those, what we call work plans. That lets you then download all of those plans to the machine. You can forward those to the machine. So when you show up in the field and it's go time, right? Like the spring, you really need to get all of your corn planted in a tight window, because that maximizes the ability for that corn to grow and produce the biggest crop for you. So at that point, you really want to go. So you get all the plans essentially from our cloud system down on the tractor. So when you pull into the field, the whole machine is ready to go.
The skills that you need as an engineer, do those change at all? Or, I mean, are you learning something new and putting something new into this? Or are you just making applications from what you already know?
Yeah, so my background is software engineering by trade, but the job really working for John Deere, especially on these projects, is really requires knowledge in the domain space. So a little bit of an understanding on agriculture, how to talk to farmers. We're always out in the field, and then already bringing in a diverse group of engineers that have background in different technologies.
It's like one-stop shopping.
We try to do that. Yes. So to essentially make it easy to get up and get the job done that day.
Jeff, thank you for your time.
Hey, thanks for stopping by.